You have done well to get this far. Your skills, they are strong. You are ready. It is time.
Time to disable force update on page load. Now the service worker lifecycle is back to normal, which is how real users will experience it. You see, force update is great during development. Say we wanted to change the theme of the app. The theme colors are in public, SCSS, theme.scss. These are a set of SAS variables referenced throughout the rest of the style sheets. If I change the primary color to red, then go back to the browser with force update enabled and refresh, boom, red toolbar. But this is because force update reloads the service worker from the network on every refresh and causes it to install even if the service worker hasn't changed. Let's say I change the whole theme by uncommenting this other set of variables here, which should make the theme green. But this time I'll disable force update on page load. Refresh the page, and still red. No matter how many times I refresh, still red. If I shift refresh and bypass the service worker, I see the changes. But normal refreshing gets me nowhere because our cache still contains the old CSS. Our cache CSS is updated as part of the install step, but that isn't happening because there's no new service worker to install. We can see from DevTools there's no new service worker waiting. Without force update, the browser checks for an update to the service worker per page load, but I didn't change the service worker, I only changed the CSS, so there's nothing new to install. We need to work with the service worker to get it to pick up changes, because we're developers, right? We change code all the time, and we need users to get those changes as soon as possible with minimum disruption. Here's how we work with the service worker lifecycle. To get the CSS to update, we need to make a change to the service worker. The browser will then treat this updated worker as a new version. Because it's new, it'll get its own install event, where it'll fetch the JavaScript, HTML, and our updated CSS, and put them in a new cache. It won't put them in a different cache automatically. We change the name of our cache to make this happen. We create a new cache because we don't want to disrupt the cache that's already there, being used by the old service worker and the pages it controls. Then, once the old service worker is released and we're ready to take over, we delete the old cache. So the next page load gets resources from the new cache, meaning it gets the latest CSS. Job done. We've already covered most of the parts needed to make this happen. We know that a change to the service worker will cause it to spin up a new instance, and that change can just be renaming the cache from V1 to V2. The bit we haven't covered is how to get rid of that old cache. The first piece of the puzzle is the activate event. We've already seen the install event, which fires when the browser sets up a new service worker for the first time, whereas the activate event fires when this service worker becomes active, when it's ready to control pages and the previous service worker is gone. This makes it the perfect time to get rid of old caches. Like the install event, you can use event.waitUntil to signal the length of the process. While you're activating, the browser will queue other service worker events such as fetch. So by the time your service worker receives its first fetch, you know you have the caches how you want them. You can delete caches using caches.delete, passing in the name of the cache. You can also get the names of all your caches using caches.keys. Both of these methods return promises.